Ladies and gentlemen, oh, sweet baby Jesus, sweet baby Skrillex, sweet baby DJ Gov, we've done it. It's Friday. Throw all your work up into the air. Set it on fire. Who cares? The weekend is pretty much upon us. Nothing else matters. Oh, it's basically the end of the world. It's absolutely fine. For 2 days, it's the end of the world. And then it's back to reality.
Padgage.
Jesus.
Get your act together.
Good to be back, guys. I know it's only been, I don't know, like 16 hours since Rankin's Records or something, but I missed you guys, you know? I'm here for you. I'm, you know, as I say, I aim to please. I'm here to help. I am your Batman. I can get you out of bed in the morning, make you a coffee, tell you that you look pretty when you're hungover, dress you lovingly, put your socks onto your little feetsies, you know, pull up the pants. Pants first, pants before, always, always pants first, actually, but even before the socks, because let's say, the cry goes out, fire at the old mill, and you've got to run up there and save, I don't know, little Jimmy Cartwright off the estate or something, who's managed to get himself stuck in the old mill and now it's on fire. The last thing you need to do is turn up there and wearing socks only and no pants. Jesus, what a startling, striking and harrowing image that would be. A fully grown man trying to rescue a boy from a burning mill wearing nothing but socks. If anything, the addition of the socks makes you more naked than if you were just completely naked. I mean, think about socks and shoes, but nothing else, is a much more harrowing image than just complete nakedness. Just think about that for a little second, would you?
Steady job, a couple extra potatoes, that's all I want.
You're getting on, you're pushing 30, Sluggy. You know, it's time to think about getting some ambition.
I always figured I'd live a little bit longer without it.
Don't forget, kid, that what you're trying to do here is to be bright and chipper and entertaining and intelligent and sort of glitzy, and that's funny, and it's kind of cool, and it's interesting, and it's edgy, and all of that. It puts that facade of momentary charisma on you, and if you don't play that out, you actually fail.
Previously on Coffee and Memes.
The EU has banned Shazam.
Yay, hooray for the EU.
I decultured it, it's a parasite on this beautiful... Oh, fuck off. Jesus Christ, grow up. Google has acquired the majority share in Burning Man. Great. Cool. Yeah.
Why?
We'll be adding our trademark Google O's as eyes for the Burning Man effigy.
Oh. Oh my God, can you think of anything worse?
Oh, please tell me, is it an April Fool's joke? Is it an April Fool's joke? Oh, it could be April Fool's. Have I just been done by an April...
No.
Yes, it is. Fucking hell. God, I'm a twat, aren't I? Jesus, Mixmag have absolutely bummed me over a barrel. No way.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence.
R.I.P. in peace. Press F for respect. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Coffee and Memes on Threshold.fm. Welcome YouTube, welcome Facebook, welcome Twitch. For some reason, unknown to me, I've decided to stream on Twitch. There's no one watching it, but I just wanted to test it out, see how it would work. Because I'm wondering whether or not they pull stuff which has got music in it. Who knows, man? Who knows? Listen, I'm here. I'm here to do business. Jesus Christ, where's Wesley Snipes gone? Fucking hell. I think he's abandoned me after yesterday's April Fool's shenanigans. He's lost all faith in the show. He's lost all faith in me as a human. He's saying I should turn in my lobster claws and just, you know, maybe go back to making dubstep or something. God bless. Jesus Christ. Listen, there's some good bits in the news today. I am going to try and get back to that human poo found in almost all solid cannabis. So that's going to be interesting. Elon Musk appears in court to fight his contempt case and is urged to put on his reasonableness pants. This is Jasper Hamill, the Metro's Elon Musk correspondent there. No shares on this one, Jasper. Sorry about that. Vegetarian food to be banned from being called burgers, sausages, and bacon. I had to do significant research to make sure that this wasn't an April Fool's, as I think it would be a good one. Because, I mean, I'm now... It's like I can't believe anything anymore. Like, I basically have had to kind of become my own version of Snopes, where I've just... Because it feels like it's basically April Fool's Day every day for the mainstream media. They're just, like, just either just make something up or they've copied something that has made something up. And then it's gone down the sort of, like, broken telephone line, three or four things in, and it just bears no resemblance to truth whatsoever.
But then we spoon it into our mouths, don't we, us sheeple? The sheeple spooning in the news, the fake news nuggets from the mainstream media.
Lobsters.
What else we got? Woman tried to eat 7 bags of heroin after being pulled over by the police. Lovely, tasty, delicious skag. Gran, 94, eats pizza for the first time since Mussolini held husband hostage. Right, okay, cool. I haven't read the article yet. I still haven't learnt my lesson about, you know, not reading. This is the thing. This is how I got myself. Look, no excuses here. I got done hard by Mixmag, but that's what happens when you don't. When you see the headline and don't read the article before reading it live on air, you see, you can get yourself into a pickle. But, you know, that's just the way I do business. You live by the sword, die by the sword. Aussie bloke arrested after gender reveal burnout. That sounds like a bit of fun. I do like a gender reveal party gone wrong. Man eats raw liver in front of vegan protesters. This is not our same spam-headed friend. These are different carnivore types. They're in Australia, I believe. And I think it is worth getting into this girl three gives baby brother Towie-style makeover to look like mummy. Oh, and also man's shame.
Lobsters.
A partner finding him disgusting after asking her to wee on him. Gonna get into that. Oh, there's all sorts of weird bits. What else? Man who had a 2-day erection has the tip of his penis amputated by doctors. That is a rough way to spend an afternoon. That really is just unfair on all counts. So, you know, again, press F for respect. Got some fucking serious bits of gear in here today. It's release date. New Signal bits. New Signal release. Exile in black. Him and Synergy. Oh, baby boy. New Current Value. Photoelectric off the Far Layer EP. Gonna play that Val remix. Auntie Val's remix. Ablaze by Mean Teeth. That, I mean... I don't know, we can get into these Signal bits, but for me, this Val remix of Mean Teeth has got Shoe Thrower of the Week written all over it. Literally, it's like it's fallen asleep at a frat house, and they've just scrawled in Sharpie Shoe Thrower of the Week all over its fat, sweating face. Christ! Hey, look, tell you what, let's get into this Signal release. Listen, wherever you are, on Facebook, on YouTube, Tell me where you are. Tell me who you are. Tell me what you're all about. Tell me what you're identifying as today. Tell me, you know, just tell me how you plan to spend the rest of your life. Hey, and we can discuss it during the next record. I love you all. Mr. Chad Ryder is in a balaclava mood today as ever. Kaylee Ness is not real. Yeah, a lot of calls for Auntie Val to be Shoe Thrower of the Week and Dinner Lady of the Week. Ooh, is the Sam Binger EP out today on Critical? Oh, God. He's got a top knot. Baby Jesus. There was a single out on the 1st. For April 1st. I hope it's not an April Fool's joke. Joe's prepared to confirm that the top knot has since been removed, so I guess we can probably play it then. that's Signal and Synergy with Exile. It's on a record label. It's on a record label. Yeah, that's a nice bet. That's a nice bet. I mean, in terms of actually lobbing footwear at stuff, though. Is it going to be Auntie Val, Dinner Lady of the Week? Hard to tell, isn't it? Well, we'll find out. Maybe we'll play that one next. Listen, let's get into the news. Man who had two-day erection has the tip of his penis amputated by doctors. Rough way to make a living. 52-year-old man from India developed gangrene on the tip of his penis. Jesus! Oh my God. Meaning doctors had no option but to amputate. Ah, it's a rough way to spend an afternoon. A man in India had to have his penis partially amputated after he developed gangrene from an erection that lasted for 2 days. Oh, what do you think? He was on the Nigerian energy drinks. Zambian energy drinks. The unnamed 52-year-old presented himself to doctors because he couldn't get rid of the painful and sustained erection. Bungling medics swiftly drained the blood from his penis, but left a catheter in and tightly dressed his penis, causing the patient to develop black gangrene. Oh, man, that's right. I can't remember what any of the samples on here now. Communist detective. Wow, doubling up on that one.
Package.
Yeah, God, Jesus, too much blood in his...
Package.
They were left with little option but to amputate after he reported back to them showing signs of severe tissue damage caused by an acute loss of blood circulation. Bungling medics have got a lot to answer for. I hate bungling medics. It's that Adam Buxton voice. I hate bungling medics. Details of the highly unusual case, which occurred at King's George Medical University in Lucknow, northern India, were published last month in the British Medical Journal. The man had been suffering from priapism, a medical term for a persistent and painful erection. So, wow, has that just happened? Is this something that can just happen? Like, it's not like you, I don't know, taken some narky gear or something and found out it's been laced with... Sendanafil, is that what it was? Sendafinil citrate? Fucking boner pills, isn't it? It's all boner pills. The man had been suffering from priapism, medical term for a persistent boner. It's not known what caused the patient's condition. All right, well, yeah, it could be the Zambian energy drinks. But experts consider an erection lasting more than 48 hours a medical emergency. So listen, young kings, more than 48 hours, that's a medical emergency, all right? It's not a laugh. It's not a game. That's your old chap you're playing with there. That you shouldn't be messing around with these things. 48 hours, remember that. If there was some sort of saying that we could concoct to, you know, to keep that front of mind. 48 hours, boner, medical emergency. Pornhub legend Mia Khalifa is actually a sweetheart, says wrestler rival. Wrestler? She a wrestler now? Joey Ryan? I just don't understand the world anymore. That could easily be an April Fool's. I've just got no idea. The NHS says priapism can be caused by sickle cell disease. Wow. Or the use of illegal or legal prescription drugs for erectile dysfunction, including Viagra. We removed his urethral catheter, Dr. Sequib Medi, wrote in the case report, but still the black colour of glands penis deepened over the next day and a clear line of demarcation became visible between it and the penile shaft. 3 weeks after the life-changing operation, the man was able to urinate as usual and now has a healthy wound. Assange to be expelled from the embassy. That's interesting. 3 weeks, Dr. Medi suggested the catheter and tight dressing put around the procedure could have triggered the gangrene in the patient. These bungling medics are out of control. Kathleen Ness asking about the Zambian energy drinks. That was from on the show a couple of days ago, not yesterday, day before. Me and Squiff were on about it. Just a little recap on that. There are these energy drinks being sold in Zambia that basically have Viagra in them. And it doesn't state on the packet that it has Viagra in it. It just says it increases libido. Anyway, it's been giving people erections you can chop wood on, and so they've banned it. However, the ban has only caused the sales to rocket. the comments are presumably suitably rabid. What a roaster up. Fucking bellend. So he's got a flattened head. What a knob. No skin off mine. Right. Okay, cool. Oh man, that's a rough way to go out. That is, so come on. Listen, young kings, be careful out there. Don't overdo it on the blueies. Don't go down that road. All right, let's see what Elon's been up to. Elon Musk appeared in court to fight contempt case and is urged to put on his reasonable pants. Elon Musk and the US financial watchdog have been urged to put on their reasonable pants following a contempt hearing brought against the billionaire over a tweet. The hearing was the latest stage of Elon's battle with the Securities and Exchange Commission, which launched the case because it believed one of his Twitter posts broke the terms of a previous legal agreement. It was feared that Tesla boss would be hit with a hefty fine and they would smack him on the body. He might be removed from his job as Tesla CEO or even banned from social media during the trial. Instead, he's decided to drop a rap record about Harambe. Oh, God, God bless him. But Judge Alison Nathan gave Musk and the SEC 2 weeks to renegotiate and clarify their previous agreement. My call to action is for everyone to take a deep breath, put your reasonable pants on, and work this out. The judge said. Judge is using the term reasonableness pants. That's so funny. Oh yeah, this is hilarious. The showdown started when Musk published a Twitter post last year saying Tesla would be taken private at $4.20 a share, allegedly choosing this number due to its significance to weed smokers because his girlfriend would find it funny. Oh God, it's too good. It's just, he really is the ultimate shitlord. Oh God, claiming that Tesla shares are going to be $4.20 a share. $4.20 plays that. Just because Grimes would find it funny. Oh, and I bet it was. I mean, it is funny. It's also potentially illegal, though. Musk was then hauled up on fraud charges and forced to seek pre-approval before publishing tweets that contain or reasonably could contain information material to Tesla or its shareholders. The SEC began proceedings against young Musk for contempt after he published a tweet in February revealing that Tesla would make around 500,000 cars. The watchdog called this post a blatant violation of the previous ruling. It was stunning to learn that Musk had not sought pre-approval for a single one of his numerous tweets about Tesla he published in the months since the court-ordered pre-approval policy went into effect. The SEC requests that this court hold Musk in contempt and impose appropriate remedy to ensure future compliance. Come on, you can't make him get rid of his... he didn't even delete it. It was in August last year. Oh, my God. That's so funny. One called it a tortured analysis and said his claim that information about Tesla production was not material to shareholders, and it says that it borders on the ridiculous. The SEC also dismissed Musk's bid to suggest the pre-approval mechanism infringes on freedom of speech, guaranteed within the First Amendment. Interesting. It said it was a frivolous argument based on misapprehension of the law and the false premise that its original order interferes with Musk's right to free speech. If the SEC is successful in winning a contempt case, it could hit Tesla with a range of punishments, which could even see Musk removed as CEO. Dun, dun, dun. Anyway, blah, blah, it goes on. Tesla remains a story of vision, steered, for better or worse, by Elon Musk. The global equities head of a firm which owns 7.7% of Tesla also recently said the company could survive the demotion of Musk, suggesting he could work as a chief ideologue instead. I think chief SoundCloud rapper would be good. We wouldn't be against him having a different role. As well as posting ill-advised tweets, Musk recently smoked weed live on the internet. A decision which may have landed him in trouble with NASA. Bollocks. Absolute bollocks. Well, good work, Muskie. You are ever entertaining. Right. Let's have this Mean Teeth Auntie Val remix. The Threshold's favourite dinner lady. Start fucking smashing the big guns. Let's see whether or not we're going to crown this shoe thrower of the week. Ridiculous. Make sure you smash that like button on Facebook and on YouTube, and don't be afraid to hit the share button. So a little reminder, You can get this as a podcast if you want. Just go to your podcast app of choice, Apple, Spotify, Overcast, Stitcher. Just search for Coffee and Memes. That bad boy will come right up. You can also get all the old episodes on the threshold.fm archive. Right here, look, it's a beautiful new website. Oh, look at it all. Oh, look at all the old episodes. You can get everyone else's as well. Roll Call, Smorgasbord Sessions, All Aboard with Darth Rankin's Records, Ames MC, Irregular Joe, Mitch Wakeholm's fucking self-help show, Combine Radio, Scientific FM, and plenty more new shows to come. Our gal Power Gem. It's going to be starting a show next Wednesday. And our boy Constrict's going at doing a monthly show. Ridiculous tune. Yeah, man, that's the Vowel remix of Mean Teeth. It's called Blaze. 420 Blaze that, yeah? Oh, I pressed something there and my headphones went off. I didn't know what was going on. It's triggered. Ah, cheers, the build. Dropping £2 in the super chat on YouTube. You're a fine gentleman. I shall spend it wisely. Yeah, that's Mean Teeth with Blaze, remixed by Val. That is, well, for me, shit. I mean, we've got this current value bit to play next, but it's going to have to put in some fucking hours if it wants to beat that. Oh, I also got this London Bass by Mob Tactics. Great record. I don't know if it's going to beat Auntie Val, though. That's, well, we'll see, won't we? Hey, listen, human poo found in nearly all street cannabis in Madrid. whose fucking dad was this written by? Street cannabis.
Well, the problem with the youth today is they're all on street drugs. You know, they listen to urban music on street drugs. And they're out there, when they get all hyped up off these groovy tunes, they go out and they want to do crimes. They're like, hi, I'm a young person. I like to do crimes, listen to groovy tunes, and smoke street drugs. Smoke street joints. Alyssa Menendez, okie dokie. So someone's mum, presumably. Next time you want to pick up cannabis on holiday in Spain, think again. Smokers are getting more than they bargained for after almost all hash sold on the streets of Madrid was found to contain fecal E. coli bacteria deemed unsuitable for consumption. Some 40% of the samples smelled of poo. That's subjective. Revealed a study of Madrid's university, Alfonso X. El Sabio Y. La. I think you pronounce the Y A. You know what? My Spanish ain't really up to scratch. Complutense. Anyway, authors of the research believe cannabis is more likely to be contaminated, due to the way it is imported, wrapped in small plastic pellets which are swallowed by smugglers. Oh, okay, so it's smuggler Todd. Righto. The mules then take laxatives to expel them into the bog, which is then sold to dealers. Analysts examined 90 samples bought directly from Madrid street dealers. Found traces of E. coli bacteria. So were they like non-street dealers? They're ones, they're like a sort of delivery service. They actually come to your house. I mean, maybe, but are they different? Are they like a bit more classy? You know, they're sort of like middle class dealers or something. I don't know. Found traces of E. coli bacteria in 93% of packages.
Package.
Aspergillus, a dangerous fungus which can cause serious health issues, contaminated 10%. Wow.
but most samples tested, 88.3%, were considered not suitable for humans. More worryingly, co-author Manuel Perez Moreno said the contaminated hash posed a serious risk to cancer patients who often consume it to counteract the side effects of chemotherapy. All right. Just lay off the hash, guys. Grow your own. He said these patients have a weakened immune system, so an infection caused by the consumption of contaminated or adulterated hashish could be fatal. Right. The risk of E. coli and Aspergillus are severe enough to make the illegal street vending of hashish a public health issue, Perez told Spanish newspaper El País, following his findings. A study published in Forensic Science International looked at two forms of cannabis resin sold in ingots, blocks, and acorns. E. coli can cause diarrhea, severe abdominal cramps, vomiting, fever, bloody stool, and an affinity with jump-up drum and bass. Wow. Most of the most virulent strains of gastroenteritis, urinary tract infections, neonatal meningitis. Wow. Oh, you've missed out the word cause there. That threw me off. But the most virulent strains can cause gastroenteritis, urinary tract infections, neonatal meningitis, hemorrhagic colitis, and Crohn's. Wow. Okay. So if you do have a compromised immune system or you don't want to smoke Todd, perhaps get your weed from somewhere other than these Madrid street dealers, okay? All right, okay, enough. Fucking hell. Sorry, in a way. Vegetarian food to be banned from being called burgers, sausages, and bacon. Okie dokie. This is, yes. The EU giveth. Veggie burgers will be getting the chop under EU plans and will instead be called veggie discs. In an EU crackdown on food labels. This is hilarious. Corn sausages will be replaced by corn tubes and soya escalops with soy slices. don't eat soy. Following a vote in the European Parliament on revisions to a food labelling regulation, Parliament's Agriculture Committee this week approved a ban on producers of vegetarian food using the terms usually deployed to describe meat, The Guardian reported. Well, you know it's legit then. The protected designations would include steak, sausage, escalope, burger and hamburger under a revised regulation that passed with an 80% approval. The proposals will be voted on by the full parliament following May's European elections, after which they will put to member states. They will be put to member states and European Commission. I did Google this to make sure that it was true, because it does sound very April Fool's-y, but no, it was published yesterday, and I can confirm that it is accurate. French socialist MEP Eric Andreu, responsible for overseeing the legislation, said the ban was common sense and appealed to Europeans' sense of foodie history. Nice. The meat lobby is not involved in this, he said. It has generated a considerable debate among the political groups, and a large majority wanted to clarify things. Particularly in the light of history, the history we share, you can have a steak or burger, you can't call it something else. The decision to protect meat-related terms and names exclusively for edible parts of animals was opposed by NGOs such as Greenpeace and BirdLife, who said it was a blow against sustainable food. Wow. It's ridiculous. I mean, the thing is, though, like those like veggie, those like fake meat burgers, like if you actually look at the list of ingredients, it's like scrapings off the floor. Like it's like bamboo sawdust. Like seriously, pea protein, bamboo sawdust, like beetroot for colouring, and like a load of like emulsifiers and stuff to sort of hold it together. Like it's, I don't even really see how it can be even that particularly classed as food. Andrea said MEPs have voted in the best interests of consumers. It should be seen as an opportunity for vegetarian brands to make their mark. We felt the steak should be kept for real steak with meat, and come up with a new moniker for all these products. I like veggie discs. Hey, let's go out for some veggie discs. It's hilarious. I mean, from an ideological standpoint, I don't know, well, a political standpoint, I don't really know how I feel about this. I don't know. Is this really what needs to be focused on? I don't know. We felt that the real steak should be kept for real steak with meat and come up with a new moniker for all these products. There's a lot to be done on this front. A lot of creativity will be needed. Molly Scott Catto, a Green MP who sits on the Agricultural Committee, said that there was suspicion that the move had come from the meat industry out of panic at the fact that young people are moving away from eating meat. It could take a number of years before the regulation comes into force as they're busy banning Spotify. Not Spotify, sorry, Shazam. Forget it. Fuck that one up. No. However, Andreu called on the EU institutions. Get on with it.
Get your act together.
Oh, lovely stuff. Okay, look, I'll tell you what. Let's have this current value bit and we can cast judgment on it. How much of a false sense of security are we going to be lulled into by the intro? I'd like them to extend this to cauliflower rice. It's not rice, it's cauliflower. Come on, guys. I mean, only just because I find it annoying. Yeah, this is a naughty bit of gear. This is called Photoelectric by Current Value. It's pretty keen, isn't it? Chode Ryder giving some... that's not a bad idea, actually. Hand-drawn memes after Article 13 comes in. Maybe I'll start tracing memes, put them up. Like, get the sort of your standard, like, meme fodder. Like, who's the old guy? Oh, God, what's he called? You know, they're all sort of like, the weird old man. Oh, I can't remember his name. Someone told me. But yeah, did we just sort of trace him, trace a little Pepe or something? Although I don't think you'd probably get done for copyright over rare Pepes. Yeah, that's Photoelectric by Current Value. It's a rowdy little number. It's a spicy meatball. Don't know what's going on with that. Woman who pleasured herself on the tube says she was just itching a rash. Woman who moaned loudly as she pleasured herself. Video required. Citation needed. As she pleasured herself on the tube for 10 minutes, claims she was just itching a rash. It's being hunted by the cops. Wow. So, Sarah Hinkson, 37, draped herself across several seats on the Hammersmith and City line and was arrested at King's Cross Station with her hands still down her jeans. Wow. She failed to appear in court, maybe due to embarrassment, and a warrant has now been issued for her arrest. Bloody hell. She's gone on the lam. Passenger Anthony Burton said he was quite taken aback at seeing Hinkston groaning and stamping her feet as her hand moved in a gyratory fashion. Oh, God. Mr. Burton, who is visually impaired in one eye, that's a compromised witness, isn't it? Told the City of London Magistrates Court he boarded at Paddington after being escorted onto the front carriage with his guide dog, a London Underground staff. He said, I suddenly became aware of a banging noise. And I thought it was something mechanical, but I noticed that to my right there was a lady who was laying out across three or four seats. She was banging her foot against the seat and the glass which was making the noise. All I could see of her hand was the top of her wrist area because the rest of the hand was in her trousers. It was around her crotch. It was blatantly obvious which part of her body it was. Her hands were moving back and forth in a sort of... This is literally... It's like a... It's like a Mills and Boone romance novel. All I could see of her hand was the top of her wrist area because the rest of her hand was in her trousers. It was around her crotch. It was blatantly obvious which part of her body it was. Her hands were moving back and forth in a sort of gyratory movement. She wasn't saying anything, but there were moans and groans of a sexual nature. I was quite taken aback. It could easily be from Morris's, one of the sex scenes from Morris's book. Mr. Burton told the court he contacted police after seeing children running through the carriage. What, running it away? Screaming in horror? It was at that point I felt uncomfortable. I thought to myself, she's not aware of her surroundings. And as much as I enjoyed the view, there were children present, and I did not want to distress their tiny, feeble minds. I felt that something should be done. That this lady was doing this, and she was totally unaware of herself, all the people around her. I wonder if she was on, some sort of dissociative drugs or something. Like, is this the sort of thing someone on GHB would do? When asked whether his impaired vision had affected what he'd seen, Mr. Burton says, I tend to turn my head to look at things so I could see her clearly. Police attended at King's Cross Station approximately 10 minutes after Mr. Burton first saw Hickson from Acton, West London. The court heard the mother of one was mostly unresponsive in her interview, but denied masturbating. She told officers, rash on my inner thigh. I was scratching a rash on my inner thigh. It comes and goes. Hickson denied one count of outraging public decency by behaving in an indecent manner, namely masturbating, on February 24th. She was convicted by magistrates and said the case had been proved beyond all reasonable doubt by the testimony of a blind man. Okie dokie. Hickson did not attend court and a warrant has been issued for her arrest. I mean, it would be rough if she, you know, properly goes on the lam and then they catch her and then they're like, yeah, so we're now doing you for not attending court and resisting arrest and all this sort of malarkey, and you end up getting banged up for rubbing one out on the tube. Like I say, it's a rough way to make a living, but you know, what are you going to do? Hey, look, let's have this mob tactics bit. It's on RAM. And it is, all by all accounts, a banger. We'll be right back. This is rowdy. Mob Tactics with LDM bass. London bass, that is. Rio the Flasher in the Discord is enjoying this one. I do not condone Rio's flashing. Maybe he's flashing his cash, who knows. Hey, if you want to join our Discord server, you're more than welcome. I'm going to post a little linky in the comments now. Yeah, this record is a dangerous threat to Auntie Val's Shoe Throw of the Week. It's a hard one to call. This was actually made by two dinner ladies called Mob Tactics. More like Mom Tactics. Yeah, that is a naughty bit. That's London Bass by Mob Tactics, out now on a little label, might have heard of it, called Ram Records. I think they're going to be big this summer. Right, last bits of news. Man's shame. The partner finding him disgusting after asking her to wee on him. Man suddenly felt curious to see what a golden shower felt like. Don't know who I feel worse for here. These are stock images. This is not the man. I mean, I'm sure the model in this is just trying to make a pound note. But I do feel like there's certain stock images like that you would model for that you know are only going to get used for stuff that would be embarrassing. I wonder how the dude who's posing there feels about him. I know he's got his face covered. He actually looks like Jack Whitehall. Maybe it is. There's another one of him there. Could be. You should be more embarrassed about how bad your comedy is. Urophilia. Undinism, golden shower, water sports, urine play, goes by many names. While it is defined as a fetish, it is nonetheless something which a number of people engage in and enjoy. Unfortunately for one man, his attempt to spice things up in the bedroom via some urine play has backfired. Poor fella. Press F for respect. Recently, I became interested in getting my partner to urinate on me. He admitted to Pamela Stevenson Connolly in a letter featured on The Guardian. I've never tried it before, and I don't know why I'm suddenly keen now, but I'm curious about what it's like, and I think it would make us feel closer. Bless him! He's just trying to generate more intimacy in the relationship. On this occasion, it had quite the opposite effect. He adds, my partner thinks I'm disgusting. Who's that? That's Pamela Stevenson Connolly. Bet she's pissed on a few geezers over the years. I feel hurt and ashamed for sharing my fantasy with her. We've been together for a few years, but I'm struggling with these negative feelings. In response, Pamela reassures the unnamed man, saying, You do not have to feel ashamed. I've no idea where accent is, but I'm going to go with this sort of nondescript one. You do not have to feel ashamed of your fantasies. Oh, she's French. You can safely enjoy them. Sounds a bit like Fred from First Dates. You can safely enjoy them while they are private to you. Yeah, but not if your missus won't piss on you. You're going to have to, well, either you're just going to have to forget about it, or you're going to have to, like, work on convincing her it's a good idea. From the sounds of it, that's not going to go well. Third, you're going to have to find someone else. So, you know, I guess you have to decide on really, you know, we all want to do things that we can't, but you've got to decide whether or not that's something that you, you know, is really, you know, that's what's going to bring meaning and value to your life. Having a young lady or an old lady, you know, or a man or anyone. I'm not, it's, you know, just a non-gender specific pisser. Just empty their bladder all over your face. If that is really what is going to, you know, drive the meaning and purpose of your life, then maybe you're going to have to, you have to bite the bullet. You have to, you know, do the right thing, take responsibility and say goodbye to your slightly more conservative lady friend. In response, Pamela reassured the... Oh, yeah, I've had that bit. However, she also issues a warning, adding, But as you have discovered, you must be cautious about sharing them, especially if they involve eroticism that may be considered edgy or unusual. You cannot go around being a fucking edgelord the whole time, demanding that everyone and the horse they rode in on piss in your face. Particularly not in your place of work. You will get fired. Rather than dwelling on his sense of shame, Pamela advises, you may take comfort in the fact that it is not uncommon to have an erotic interest in urine, and that erotic play involving it can take many forms. Perhaps while your partner is taking a piss, you can run in and try to scoop up some piss in a small ramekin and then sling it into your face. She does, however, caution him about pushing the matter with his partner, since the idea of combining urine and eroticism is a turn-off for your partner. It is best not to pursue the idea of realizing it. Well, that's it, is it? See what the comments have to say. I can only imagine they're suitably rabid. She should indulge herself just once in his family, in his fantasy family. Ask Katie Price. She's always. She should indulge herself just once. This is Jake Clark, 2 days ago, commenting on the Mirror. She should indulge herself just once in his fantasy. You never know, she may enjoy it. A healthy relationship should mean that both can experiment with their partner's desires to try new things. If they can't agree, then move on to something else. Disgust with an unusual suggestion, particularly without trying it first, to me, suggests being stuck in a rut. Fee comments, don't feel disgusted or ashamed. Many women are inhibited when it comes to sex fantasies and erotic sex. There's nothing disgusting about golden showers. She obviously doesn't squirt. She obviously doesn't squirt. It pretty much the same. What? Oh, she obviously doesn't squirt. It's pretty much the same. Hey, don't. Just leave that. leave her. She's clearly not right upstairs. Bill Wiz. All right, a slightly reductive response there. Can't fault him. What's wrong with you, woman? All right, okay. I see we're delving into that part of the internet, are we? All right. Okay, well, look, it's kind of the end of the show, pretty much. I'm going to finish on this Aggressive Bunks bit, which is new, out on Eat Brain. You know Eat Brain? It's called Acid Mirage. It's rowdy. Look, as much as I love that Mob Tactics bit, I am going to go with Auntie Val's remix of Mean Teeth for Shoe Thrower of the Week. Unless just out of left field, Bunks comes in with the fucking goods. It's possible. Keep rocking!
Jesus, Bunk's putting work in, isn't he? Scat. On a quiet week, it's easy. Easy could have been Shoe Thrower of the Week. Oh, but it's been a good week. Hey, listen, just time to shout out the VIP list. This is a list of fine, fine, wonderful humans. Humans, men, women, lobsters, a lot of them. Who are supporting the show financially every month for $10 a month or more on our Patreon page. If you would like to do such a thing, you get many, many perks. You get £5 a month to spend in the Threshold merch store. I've got some new bits that will be going up next week in there. We've got t-shirts, we'll have mugs, we'll have all sorts of bits. Oh, bloody hell, it's a good fucking record, isn't it? You get £5 a month to spend on merch. You get your name on the VIP list read out at the end of every show. You're going to get your name in the next version of the app on the founders list. You get, I can't even now remember off the top of my head. Oh, there we go. You get access to the private VIP lounge on the Discord server and join the Green Gang. You get a pack of stickers. I don't have any around here. You get a pack of stickers sent to you. And you get the smug sense of satisfaction that you're helping Threshold become bigger and better. So you can join the ranks of Oliver Hooper, Nicholas Gonclaus, Tom Ryan, Reese Musson, Squidgy Beats, Parsons, Paulie Hutton, Kieran R, Michael Kaczynski, Matthew Tompkins, Dave Long, Joel Potter, Cole Murphy, Sam Howard, Tony J, Richard Patterson, Jack Murphy, Tom Cam, Stephen Harris, Matthew Bullard, Zara Pickle, Jerome Van Thunderbutt, Mike Pye, Anthony Walker, Lily Unsub, Richard Franks, Thomas Hall, Chode Ryder, Andrew Hushabek, John Finneson, the BDR crew, Peter Blatchford, Austin Grief, Cooper, Gennady Lightfield, Ryan Glazer, James Parry, Dave Thompson, Hendo Bartendo, Lady Scrivington, Liam the Menace Underwood, Dan Fucking Morris, a guy with no STDs, Justin Mercer, Ames MC, Josh Williams, Rob Humphrey, Shibby T, Coco Shiva, Dan Elton, Tyron Wilwell, Mr. Pope, Dark Progressive, Trance is actually superior to drum and bass. Nicholas Lawsey, Damon Reynolds, Chris Breaks the Bill, Carissa Barthelson, Odin Bates, Lee Fuller D, Daniel Genvey, Flaxis, Alexander Cassidy, Matt Wright, Dylan Laws, Grant Sullivan, not that, Tom Robinson, subscribe on YouTube, Greg Cornford, Grace Sellers, and Dab Smasher. That is growing by the day, that list. I am unbelievably grateful to everyone that is supporting financially. If you want to, you can go to our Patreon page, either go to Patreon.com/ThresholdFM, or there is a link in the YouTube description, or just go to threshold.fm and there is a donate section, and all the information you will ever need is there. So everybody who is supporting everyone on that list, you've got £5 in credit in your account. I've set everyone up an account on threshold.fm. You might need to activate it. An email will have gone out. But there's a fiver in there. Next month, there'll be another fiver in there, which will, and it'll add up. You can either use it just to get a discount on stuff, or you can wait until there's enough to just buy something outright, a t-shirt, a mug. There'll be some hats. There'll be, got some cool fridge magnets coming soon. It's going to be all sorts of bits. I may even start getting some music up. It might be an interesting direction to take things in. Anyway, look, thanks so much for listening this week. It's been a lot of fun. Thanks to Squiff for joining me on Wednesday. Thanks to everyone who is joining me on this crazy freaking ride. I'm thoroughly enjoying it. I could not do it without you. I could not do it without you all listening and encouraging me and enjoying it. If you stop enjoying it, please do tell me why, as maybe something's gone wrong. Until then, have a good weekend. Be nice to yourselves. Be nice to each other. Work out. Eat some good food. Do something nice for someone else. And just generally be a good human being. Be responsible. Look for the meaning in the world. Look for, try and find a purpose. Maybe that purpose is helping other people. Maybe that purpose is jump up drum and bass. No. Could be. Who am I to say? I love you all. I'll see you next week. God bless you.